Hello everyone. Welcome to the psychology course. We will begin with chapter 1, the history and scope of psychology. In this chapter, we will firstly talk about the definition of psychology and then the history of psychology, different approaches for studying human behavior, and lastly, subareas of psychology. Let's start with the definition of psychology. It has been so long time humans are in the world, and it has been so long time humans have been asking questions about themselves and the others. Psychology as a discipline also asks questions about humans and aims to understand a large variety of human behavior. Accordingly, psychology regards humans as biological, social, and psychological creatures and aims to understand biological, social, and psychological bases of their behavior. In order to explain biological bases of behavior, psychology asks questions such as how heredity shapes human behavior, how hormonal changes influence our feelings, and how the nervous system functions in relation with our responses to the environment. In order to explain social bases of behavior, psychology asks questions such as how environment shapes human behavior, how the others influence our way of life, how we behave in groups. In order to explain psychological bases of behavior, psychology asks questions such as how our beliefs, values, and attitudes relate to each other, and how our political ideologies relate to our behaviors. What it studies is important for psychology, but it is also so important for psychology how it studies what it studies. A given response to this question is likely to determine psychology's existence as a scientific discipline. In the explanation of behavior, researchers in psychology must follow some scientific rules. Now we should move on to the history of psychology. Psychology separated from philosophy and became a discipline on its own right in the late 19th century. It has come to be accepted as an independent discipline with the foundation of its own laboratory and development of its own methodology. Indeed, the human behavior has always drawn the interest of scholars from other disciplines such as philosophy, sociology, anthropology, biology, physiology, medicine, and computer science. The relationship between the human mind, which is the center of consciousness, ideas, and thoughts, and the human body, which is the physical or material part, has largely been discussed in philosophy. It has been questioned whether they exist separately or are a part of the same entity. The idea that they are separate or the mind is something spiritual and non-physical implied that the mind is not available to study scientifically. Now let's have a look at the different approaches for studying human behavior. Since the beginning of psychology, there have been different approaches to the study of human behavior. These approaches provided a variety of viewpoints for psychology to understand complicated human behavior better. Although some of these approaches, structuralism and functionalism, are not valid today, each made valuable contribution to the development of psychology as an independent discipline. Structuralism suggested that psychology should study human mind by discovering the structures of consciousness. Functionalism emerged in the USA as an alternative to structuralism. Functionalism suggested that psychology should study human mind by discovering the functions of consciousness. It suggested that psychology should question what consequences or functions the behavior has in a given environment or how it is useful in a particular condition. Psychoanalysis approach was founded by Sigmund Freud. He suggested that psychology should study human mind by discovering the unconscious processes. Sigmund Freud was a neurologist and observed and talked with people having psychological problems. He concluded that early life experiences, which people are mostly unaware of, play an important role in the development of these problems. He proposed a theory of personality development and a method of psychotherapy. Behaviorism approach, which emerged in the USA, suggested that psychology should study the observable behavior. Behaviorism was influenced by functionalism and empiricism. It emphasized the relationship between behavior and environment. It suggested that psychology should question what happens in people's environment and how they behave accordingly. Gestalt psychology was a reaction against structuralism, which attempted to divide human experience or consciousness into its elements. According to Gestalt psychology, individual elements of any experience cannot explain the experience itself. This approach argued that the human mind organizes the experience in the way that is not reducible to the sum of its parts. It suggested that elements of any experience interact with each other, and humans perceive a pattern or a whole of these interactions, which takes place across time and/or space. Humanistic perspective emerged in the mid-20th century. It suggested that psychology should study the conscious processes or experiences. This approach was in contrast with the approaches of psychoanalysis and behaviorism, both representing humans as not powerful enough to control their own behavior. Cognitive perspective suggested that psychology should study how mental processes influence the human behavior. According to cognitive perspective, how humans process the information or the stimuli in the environment influence how they behave. There are also some sub-areas of psychology. Psychology has an interest in a variety of human behaviors occurring in a variety of contexts. This led modern psychology to divide into so many areas of specialization. Psychology has some main sub-areas such as social psychology, clinical psychology, developmental psychology, and industrial and organizational psychology. These sub-areas are relatively old and extensively contributed to the theoretical, empirical, and methodological development of psychology. Psychology has also some relatively young and small sub-areas, such as traffic psychology, health psychology, psychology of religion, music psychology, sports psychology, forensic psychology, family psychology, and political psychology. Parallel to social, cultural, and economic changes in the world, psychology is gaining new sub-areas and becoming larger. So, this is the end of our program for Chapter 1 of the psychology course. Goodbye, and see you in our next program, Chapter 2.